prosper as your soul prosper. May your heart forever be in posture to receive mercy, glory from above. May you prosper as your soul so prosper. May your heart forever be in posture to receive mercy, glory from above.
Tell it everywhere.
I tell it everywhere.
Service. I want you all to start humbling your minds and your hearts as we go to God in prayer. Oh, most gracious God, we come to you today just to say thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for allowing us to commune together as a church. We pray right now that your spirit reigns on us, that your presence be known in this place, that any burden that we may have, we release it right now to you in the name of Jesus. We pray that you allow people to share their testimony that somebody else may be blessed. Thank you so much for what you're going to do right now and in the future. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Come on this evening. Can you stand with us? We're going to sing praises to the King.
Yeah. Stand on up.
We sing praises.
We sing the praises to our King, for he is the King of Kings. We sing the praises to our King, for he's the King of Kings.
We sing
the praises to our King, for he is the King of Kings. We sing the praises to our King, for he's the King of Kings. Give him glory, for he's the King of Kings. Give him glory, for he's the King of Kings.
Give him glory.
Give him glory, for he's the King of Kings. Give him glory, for he's the King of Kings.
We sing praises.
We sing the praises to our King, for he is the King of Kings. We sing the praises to our King, for he's the King of Kings.
We sing
the praises to our King, for he is the King of Kings. We sing the praises to our King, for he's the King of Kings.
Give him glory.
Give him glory, for he's the King of Kings. Give him glory, for he's the King of Kings.
Give him glory.
For he's the King of Kings.
Give him
glory. For he's the King of Kings.
All
hail King Jesus.
Woo. All hail Emmanuel.
All hail Emmanuel.
We're singing to our King this evening. Anybody got a praise for Jesus?
Hallelujah. We need you to fill this place, Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, we give you glory, Lord, yeah. I'm waiting for this day. Yes, the world will bow down and say you are God. Every man will bow down and say you are King. So let's start right now. Why would we wait? I just want to be with you. just want to be with you. I just want to be with you. Yes, the world,
yes, the world
will bow down.
Will bow down and say you are God.
Every
man
will bow down.
Will bow down and say you are King.
So let's start.
So let's start right now.
So we'll sing hallelujah till you come again.
Yes, Lord. Yes,
Lord. And we'll dance in your presence till you come again.
Yeah.
I will sing in your presence until you come again. And I'll dance in your presence till you come again, and we'll sing hallelujah.
Sing hallelujah till you come again.
Oh, and we'll dance in your presence, Lord.
We'll dance in your presence till you come again.
Oh, your name, Jesus.
Jesus. Come on and bless your name, Jesus. He's in the presence this morning. He's in the presence this evening. He's in your presence every day. Hallelujah. You just want to need to be with him, Lord. Hallelujah.
Just to be close to you.
Hallelujah. Yes, God.
Just to be close to you.
Yes, God.
Just to be close to you is my desire. Just to be close to you.
Yes, God.
Just to be close to you. Just to be closer to you is my desire. Help me say, just to
be close to you.
Just to be where you are.
Just to be close to you.
To dwell in your presence.
Just to be close to you.
That's my desire.
That's my
just to dwell in your presence.
Just to be close to you.
To know you in the fullness of
just
it.
Just to be close to you.
To experience you in all
just
of your glory.
Just to be close to
that's
you.
It is our desire to be close to you, O God. We ask that you would have your way in this place. Lord, we might as well start revival early on tonight. We say thank you for allowing us to make it through a rainy Wednesday on today. We ask that your spirit would rain down upon this place. Bless all those whose hearts and minds are here, whose spirits are here, and whose presence is here. Be with those who are even watching online right now. That the sweet spirit that finds its way in this place, that would find its way to where they are, wherever they might be watching on tonight. And we'll give your name all the glory and the honor and the praise. You are still a worthy God. You are still a God who knows all and sees all, whose light we cannot help but bask in. Lord, we just want to be close to you.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
For we know that being closer to you, there's peace in our hearts. When we're closer to you, questions that can't be answered seem answerable. It's in your presence that we find strength in our weakness, healing in our bodies, and guidance for our souls. It's in your presence. We say thank you. In the Master's and mighty name of Jesus the Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen. Good evening, everybody. Tonight, we're going to do things just a little bit differently, and I want to start us off with testimony on tonight. So if you desire to share what the Lord might have on your heart on tonight, please do so. And so we have our microphones here. Permit me to begin. I'm tired tonight, if I'm going to be honest with you. I'm tired tonight. It you have to be careful when you do spiritual stuff because the enemy likes to be busy. And so I'm tired tonight, but I'd rather be tired than defeated. And so God is good. God is good. Thank you for all your prayers. Both of my parents are home, safe and sound on tonight. So we thank God for that. And God is a healer. And so we thank God for that. Anyone else care to share on tonight? I know I don't mind sitting in silence until y'all get ready.
Church family, I just like to thank God for just having a church to come to and for people to show up to meet you here with a smile. There's so many places around the world where people want to come and pray and they want to give testimonies, and they are not allowed to. If they came, it would be their life. So I just thank God for having a church family and a place to come and give a testimony. Sometimes we get so overwhelmed because it is so much that's going on in the world, and we think about it sometimes more than we pray about it. So I've been doing a lot of praying over this Lent season. Might be lack of sugar that makes you pray like you pray. Just saying. But it makes you think, and it makes you appreciate all the things that you thought you couldn't get through. Amen. And it gives you a new taste on life. It gives you a new taste on God. He permeates your soul, and he tells you as you read his word and you study what prayer is about, you don't have to try to figure it out or fix it, because God has already worked it out. Does not mean you won't have bad days or sad days and things won't come, but trust and believe he's already worked it out. Amen.
Amen. Hello, everybody. Oh, hello. Yes, okay. Good evening. My name is Charmaine, for y'all that don't know. I just want to share a little bit about really who I am and what I've been experiencing. So I think March 19th, thanks to my sister Asia, she reminded me that was my year anniversary of when I became a member of Macedonia. Thank you. It has been such a joyous experience having a church home. I've always obviously believed in God, Jesus Christ as my Savior. I grew up, you know, in church and things like that, but of course I got away from it. My family church is Union Baptist Church, not too far from here. But I decided to step out on my own and kind of have my own journey as far as, like, you know, my own spiritual journey and things like that. So when I decided to join Macedonia, like, literally, it's been like the best decision that I could have made, like, in my life. A couple of things. I do not volunteer to do, like, public speaking, like, things like this. I would have just, like, sat right there and just kind of listened with everyone. Sorry, I'm gonna get you. But I feel like, you know, in this season that I've been in, especially the last couple of months, it's just been like some miraculous things like happening to me. I joined a book club called Dangerous Prayers. And the book is called Dangerous Prayers. And in the book, it kind of opens you up and teaches you how to pray these prayers, these scary prayers that you are afraid to pray because you don't know if, like, you're ready for God to start moving in your life. And so I obviously completed the book club recently. I started praying these prayers because I was in a situation or a season. I'm still in that season where I need God to shake and move things in my life. And so I feel like once I became intentional with those prayers, the kind of things I was praying, the things I was saying, whether I was ready or not, things just started happening. And specifically, I'll talk about two things in my spiritual world with church here in Macedonia, and then the second one with my career. So with really quickly with my career, again, I'm not a public speaker. It's not to say that I can't. I just don't. Like, I don't know. Like, I'm just shy. And so I decided, like, something was itching me the end of 2023. Like, you've been on your job. I work for the VA, the Veterans Administration. So something was like, you know, you've been on your job for 3.5 years. You need to get more into professional development, maybe get into leadership, you know, step out on faith, like push yourself out there, things like that. So I interviewed for a leadership program within my agency. I got accepted, so I'm in it now. Within the leadership program, I'm, you know, obviously meeting new people that are in leadership. They're kind of sharing things about that I feel like I have the same things going on as far as like being afraid to speak, like being afraid to lead, all these things without me even saying what my scares were, what my fears were. And I'm like, wow, like these people were in like big top positions and they have like this fear of speaking, this fear of leading people, all this stuff. So I'm like, wow, they can do it. Like, you know, I can do it. So the leadership program isn't over until August, so I'm still in it. But in the midst of it, I saw a leadership opportunity, such as a job position, and I decided to apply for it. So I applied for it, which, again, is something that I would never do, and I got an interview. And so I interviewed for it, and I told myself, like, okay, this was about 2 weeks ago, and I told myself, okay, if I get the job, I'll share my testimony on the last prayer circle, which is today. I haven't heard anything yet, but I've been getting good signs that maybe they're thinking about me. I don't know. Like, they're calling my references, things like that. But clearly, I haven't heard anything yet. But then when the sermon that just passed this past Sunday, and Pastor was talking about sharing your testimony regardless of what you feel like you can get out of it or what you're going to get out of it, because you don't know who you're going to help. You don't know what's going to happen. So I could be talking to someone and they could be like, wow, like you did that? Like, I've been scared too. I'm going to do that, you know? And I had that situation happen to me recently yesterday. I'm thinking I'm talking to someone that can give me pointers about like how HR work and all this stuff. And she like, girl, that's crazy. I'm proud of you, but I had a position come about and I let it pass because I was scared. But so you motivating me. And I instantly thought about the sermon. So I said, okay, you know what? Whatever happens, happens. I took advantage of the opportunity. I'm proud of myself. That's that, right? So just keep me in y'all prayers that I get that job. Anyway, so with church, okay, and Miss Terry is staring me dead in my face right now, but with church, okay? So, of course, I joined church this time last year. You know, I was just kind of like getting my seat warm, feeling my way, things like that. Of course, again, I'm not a person that's really going volunteer. Like, you got to push me out there for me to, like, volunteer for something. So two things happen. The first thing is that when I first joined, I was kind of saying, to be transparent, like, I don't know if I'm going to get too involved. I'm just coming to find a church home. I'm just going to sit back, listen to Pastor preach, and go home. Well, that was not the plan for me because it was one Sunday where there was like a ministry fair. I did not come to church that Sunday just because I guess it was bad weather. I don't know what happened. And so that was the day that it was the ministry fair. And so I missed it. But I got a call not too long after that asking me like if I would be willing to join a particular ministry. I ain't going to share that yet. Y'all see it later on. If I would be willing to join a particular ministry, and I felt in my spirit to say yes. But I also felt nervous and scared, and, you know, I did express that. Like, I don't know if this for me. Like, I don't know. I'm about to back out. But then as I continued to kind of, like, share my fears with people, I prayed on it, asking God to stretch me, use me where he see fit, and all those things. As I continued to go, you know, to those meetings and surround myself around those ladies, it was definitely just, like, my fear is gone now. Then recently, and I'm almost about to wrap it up, but then recently, I would see people doing a responsive reading. And I would always wonder, mind you, I'm new to church, so I would always wonder, how do people get selected for that? And the reason why I was always wondering that is because I never wanted to do it. So I'm like, if I know how it's happening, I'm never going to get picked because it's no way I'm going up there. Literally, it was like two Wednesdays ago. I'm here at prayer circle. I'm minding my business. I'm talking to my friends. Next thing you know, I hear somebody like, Charmaine. I'm turning around like, huh? It's Miss Terry. And she like, can you do the responsive reading on Sunday? I'm like, oh my God. Like inside, I'm just like, oh my goodness. But then out my mouth, I said, yes. Like, yes, I'm going to do it. And I was nervous about it. I'm talking to my friends like, bro, I never did nothing like that before. Like, wait, what if I can't pronounce a certain name in the Bible? Like, what if I mess up? Like, I was just like freaking out. So what calmed my spirit is Deaconess Lee. She reached out to me and sent me, like, obviously I didn't know this, but, you know, obviously Pastor Wade has created like a practice video and he tells you how to get comfortable and all this stuff. They send you the scripture ahead of time. I'm in my house practicing, reading the scripture. And then it even made me like go further into the scripture. So I feel like last Sunday when you preached and you did the responsive reading, that Sunday I already knew what was happening. So it's kind of pushing me like further into my word, further into like just like God's grace. Like, I mean, it's just like amazing. Like when you feel like you have a certain plan for your life or when you speak out and say what you're not going to do. And then God just starts showing up and he just start moving. He start pushing you. And it's like, you know, I just feel like I'm where I'm supposed to be. Like I'm called to, whether it's in my job or whether it's here, everything is like aligned. Like my personal life, my spiritual world, my professional world, it's all like aligned to be like exactly what is happening for me. So I'm just going to let God use me. And I thank y'all. Y'all my family. And thank y'all.
I think I need a microphone. Good evening, people at home. How you doing? Look, I just want to tell you that I'm thankful that I'm here this evening. But I'm doubly thankful. My road partner told me, said, since he's on spring break and school, she said to me, Granddaddy, I want to go to church. Stand up, Brittany. If you all don't know her, she's been here since day one. And she's been prayed for and prayed on. And when she tells me, say, Granddaddy, I want to go to church, that's what Granddaddy does. But I'm glad to be in this service one more time. Thank you.
Good evening. How y'all doing? Charmaine. You did. You got people up, get ready to testify. You fired people up because I wasn't going to say anything. But this week, Tuesday morning, you know, we all woke up to a catastrophe that's going to have implications on the whole coast for 5 to 10 to 20 years out. And when I woke up, I thought it was a joke because 13 years ago, it was my responsibility to drive over that bridge several times within an hour to conduct checks. I've been under the bridge. I've been on top of the bridge. I've worked by the bridge. And when I saw it, just like everybody else, I was in disbelief. How could this happen? And I began to pray because a lot of times I question why God would close doors and open other doors. And it just shows the dispensation of grace and his divine plan for your life when you see things happen and where you were and where you are now. And I just got filled. I'm overwhelmed now talking about it because I heard the news reports coming out like everyone else, and I started worshiping God for the one soul that was saved and was able to deny care. And anybody who works in the medical industry or a first responder, if they allow you to deny care or transport to the hospital, that means that they trust that you're okay. That one person and I don't know what their faith is, but God saved them. And through all of that, that one person can say, well, now there are two people who have been released from the hospital. They can say, they survived that. That alone, if that can't show you what God can do in your life, not only do you have to worship and praise through your own trials and tribulations, but you got to worship and praise for other people's trials and tribulations as you see them walk through them and use them as your motivation to keep your faith, to keep reading your word, to keep coming to church. And that right there, it while it's sad, all at the same time, I'm just amazed at the goodness of God and the things that he can do. And when I was talking to my children, and you all know my crew, whew, Jesus, they are some special and unique individuals. All of our little ones are, and they're so precious. But when I explained it to them, because I knew they were going to go to school and see these things, and their teachers talked to them about them, I wanted to tell them first. So I let them know what was gonna what happened, and I let them see the video. And you know, the middle one looked at me and said, "Mommy, I'm gonna pray for them." I'm in tears because the parents, they know, like, we teach them, but when they come back at you with the same things that you taught them, you understand. They're listening. They hear everything you're saying, and they also believe in the power of prayer. On the way to church, I mentioned something else about it, and, you know, we joke about the fast, and we have our children fasting from sugar. Like, you know, they're learning the things that have sugar in them, and it's really like, wow, mommy, really? And my oldest son goes, you know what this Sunday is? I was like, it's Resurrection Sunday. Are you excited? He's like, no, it's the day we celebrate. We're finishing our fast. And just all of that combined and them understanding and being able to comprehend that at such a young age, we just have to be grateful for everything. Great, big, small, medium size, every blessing, everything that God has given to us is just marvelous. And this week, although we've had the catastrophe, every day I've been overwhelmed with the things that I've seen happen and just reflecting on the things that God has protected me from. It's just amazing. And that's all I have to say is just to be encouraged. Continue your walk with God. Don't ever think that things that you're doing are in vain or no one's paying attention to or they don't see it, because it's everything makes a difference in the kingdom of God. So you guys be blessed. I love each and every one of you. Macedonia is so wonderful.
Anyone else? All right. Come on, come on.
I'm also shy, but listening to you kind of encouraged me. I come to service, well, first of all, hello, church family. I've been coming to church every Wednesday, been wanting to give my testimony about how God has been opening up so many doors in my life. I've been coming to the church since I was a baby, thanks to my godmother, Yvette Welcher. I strayed away for a long time because I hooked up with a man who I thought was going to love me forever, who was my husband. I had kids by him. And for some odd reason, I worshiped him more than what I worship God. And it was times where I felt like I wanted to come back to church, but then I was worried about how he would feel if I came to church. So I stayed away, and at night I would just get on my knees and I would just pray and just ask God, if this isn't for me, then remove him out of my life. And I prayed that prayer not knowing that if that's what I really wanted to do. So it came a point in our marriage where he was just doing so many things to me. And I asked God, God, why me? And he said to me one day, why not you? So we separated. He went his way. And I just thought my life was over. Like, here it is, a man that I thought loved me. I worshiped the ground he walked on. And he left me with to raise three sons by myself. So thanks to the support of my mother, who is like the backbone, who helped me tremendously with my kids, I just simply was like, Lord, what is your plan for my life? So I never stayed away. I always prayed. And so happened one day I ran into Terry at Walgreens. And she said, I miss you. How you been? I was like, I'm doing good. She said, won't you come back to church? You know, it's COVID, but still come. So I said, okay, Terry. So when I left, I sat in the car, and I was just honestly, like, embarrassed. Like, I don't know if I want to go back. I don't want people to ask me questions, like, where you been? So I was like, all right, I'm going to think about it. So one day, I decided to come back. It was like 3 years ago. I came back, and when I tell you, it has been the best experience ever. God has opened up so many doors. I have gotten three promotions on my job, and I just want to encourage anyone to never not put God first. Always keep him as the head of your life, and as long as you trust him, he will direct your path.
God is good, and all the time. Amen. Amen. I need the old, I need thee. God, we come right now at your throne one more time. First of all, just to say thank you. Thank you for being a great God. Thank you for being the God of our salvation. We are not remiss that this is Holy Week. This is the week that your son paid it all. Lord, we can talk about a whole lot of things, but Lord, we thank you for salvation on tonight. We thank you that you love us enough that you're willing to pay the ultimate sacrifice that we can call upon your righteous name. We thank you that by following you, there is still hope for us. We thank you that because your son died on Calvary's cross, that there is victory in your name. We come now on this last night of prayer service, and I come just simply to talk to you on behalf of a few of your children. First off, Lord, we intercede in behalf of this great city of Baltimore tonight. Tragedy has struck this city once again. We talk about how you are a bridge over troubled waters. Well, the bridge has collapsed on us. First, we say thank you for the lives that have already been rescued on tonight. We thank you that you're still in the saving business, that there are no waters too deep that you cannot get us out of. Lord, we pray for the families of those who are still missing loved ones on tonight. We pray, oh Lord, that even when we can't make sense of how this could have happened, Lord, we pray that we'll understand it better by and by. Lord, I pray that it's in these tragic moments that seem senseless, that don't make sense, that we learn to lean on you just a little bit more. It's moments like these where we realize we just don't know everything, and we just have to trust you. I pray that it's moments like these that will bring people closer together, that we will show more humanity and love for one another. We have enough people who are going to tear us down. We have enough people who are going to hurt us, Lord, but spread some love on this city tonight. And pray for our government officials who have to answer unanswerable questions. And pray, oh Lord, that you would make Charm City a Christ-centered city, oh God. I pray that this branch of Zion itself might be a light in the midst of moments of darkness. We heard of tonight of your great power, that just by relying on you a little bit more, you have a way of making ways out of no way. We've heard on tonight that you still can give promotions in a short amount of time, that you can open doors that we were afraid to walk in. I pray for people to take leaps of faith, oh God. Pray for every person who is walking in a spirit of fear, anxiety, that they're doubting, self-doubt, and low self-esteem on tonight. I pray, oh God, that you will give them the courage of Joshua on tonight, that you'll give them the courage to stand boldly. I pray that you'll give them the courage of an Esther tonight, and that they'll be able to stand before kings even at the risk of death, knowing that you're pushing them, propelling them forward, oh God. I pray that when they look at themselves in the mirror, they see a beautiful soul created by your divine hands. Your word says that we are beautifully and wonderfully made. God, I pray that you would ease every moment of anxiety on tonight. People who are laden with fears that they can't express on tonight, I pray that you'll lift the burdens from them, oh God. I pray, oh Lord, for healing in this place. I don't know who is in need of it, but I pray that you will touch bodies on tonight. That you'll touch bodies from the crown of their head to the soles of their feet. I pray that you'll be able to do not just normal healing, but I pray that I'm crazy enough to believe that you still do miraculous healings. I want to hear, oh Lord, of your great witness of power. that it confuses and bewilders doctors. They don't even know how the tumor got expedited, oh God. They don't even know how they're walking right now. They don't know how they haven't lost their mind, oh God. I pray for supernatural healing in this place. I pray, oh Lord, that you will find ways of being able to make your supernatural power evident in this branch of Zion, oh God. We've already heard that people feel that they've already made the best decision by joining this branch of Zion. I pray it's contagious. I pray, oh Lord, that others would feel heaven in this place. I pray that when we go into where we might go, that Macedonia, even in Walgreens, can evangelize to somebody, that even in the Walmarts and at the gas station, at the job, oh God, that there's something about the dew that falls on this ground, that this is fertile soil, that which we do would yield upon your spirit, oh God, that people would be made straight. I pray for every person on the precipice of a new beginning, on the precipice of becoming more than what they are now. I pray, oh Lord, for every person who sees more than what they see right now. I pray for vision and I pray for guidance, oh God. I pray, oh Lord, that you would make this place not just holy ground, but anointed ground, oh God. I pray that it gives demons goosebumps to come by this building. I pray that it gives witches and warlocks trembling feelings when they come through the place, oh God. I bind any spirit of dysfunction out of this place. I pray, oh God, that we will be exceeding and abundantly above all we could ever ask or think. I pray, as Miss Charmaine has already told us, that we'll pray dangerous prayers, oh God, that we'll ask for crazy stuff. I'm crazy enough to believe that eyes still have not seen and ears still have not heard, God. I am crazy enough to believe that people still have not seen what Macedonia is to become in the future. I pray for every person who has their own personal dream, has their own personal vision, that you'll walk them through it, oh God, that you'll guide them along the way. I pray that you'll dispatch angels, oh God, for every family represented under the sound of my voice, oh God. I pray for households on tonight. I pray that you'll show up not in just the church house, but in their houses, oh God, that you'll bless them, oh God, just like you did the people of Israel in Exodus, oh God, that you will pass the death angel over their houses because the blood of the lamb was on the doorpost. I pray that you'll protect houses, oh God, from any attack, oh God. I pray that you'll protect households from broken marriages. I pray that you'll protect our children and our most vulnerable, oh God. I pray for our elders, oh God, on tonight. I pray that you will shower down upon us as only you can do. I still believe that you still are able to break every chain that is holding us bound. I still believe that you're still able to make ways out of no ways. I pray, oh God, for men in this church. I pray that you'll raise up another generation of men, oh God, who will stand strong and represent mighty as men of God. I pray that you'll give them the confidence and the strength to represent your kingdom as kingdom men, oh God. I pray for every woman, oh God, in this place, that they will find themselves to be strong and courageous, that they will walk in the spirit of truth and love, and they will walk in the grace and the strength and mercy. I pray that this church would be stronger than ever before, oh God. I pray for revival to hit this house, oh God, in a mighty way over the next month of April, oh God. I pray, oh Lord, that every revivalist will touch our hearts and touch our minds and touch our souls. I pray people will come to know you. We lift the Savior up, oh God, for you say if you would be lifted up, you will draw all men unto me. We lift up Jesus in this house, oh God. There is no greater name than Jesus. He is still our lily of the valley. He is still our bright and morning star. Jesus, who is our way maker. Jesus, Mary's baby. Jesus, we call on that name. Jesus, that every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess. It's Jesus, oh God, that we lift up in this place, high and lifted up, oh God. We claim Jesus in this house. We say thank you, God, for being a God who's ever present. We say thank you, God, for being a God who is powerful. We say thank you, God, for being a God who is strong when we find ourselves weak, oh God. We say thank you, God, for being our strong tower. We say thank you, God, for being our redeemer. We thank you that you've protected us from ourselves. Forgive us for our sins. Forgive us for the ways in which we failed to represent you, to live up to your calling. Forgive us, oh God, but clean us up by the precious blood of Jesus. Clean us by the blood of the Lamb, that you would restore and renew in us. Your blood still has power, and so we know that your blood can cleanse us, oh God. We just ask that you would forgive us and make us straight upon your path, oh God. We pray, oh Lord, that you would be our righteous reigning King. There still is none like you. There still is none like you. There still is none like you. Lord, we thank you that prayer has brought us together. There is something that happens when the church prays. We feel it, we see it, that there's something changing about us spiritually. This is not about physical stuff. This is not just about what we see, but Lord, this is about the unseen. Faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Lord, give us the faith to see it, to make this place feel like heaven. That's the only vision I believe you've given to us. That when people see Macedonia and experience Macedonia, that they experience heaven. That they know your presence is real in their lives. God, I pray that people would hear your voice who've never heard your voice before. I pray that people who've never experienced your presence would feel it for the first time. I pray that we would not just have an emotionalism, but we would truly understand the power of your word. That every time we shout for joy, we know why we shout. We know why we scream. We know why we yell. Lord, we intercede on behalf of members of our community tonight. We pray for the family of Deaconess Frances Williams on tonight. We thank you for this legendary life that you've given this branch of Zion, who committed her life to serving you. Her impact is long and far. We thank you for the pillar that she has been for 88 years. I ask that you would be with her family right now. Be with her son, Tim, tonight. Be with her sisters, oh God. Be with her nieces, nephews, her children, her grandchildren, great-grandchildren. Lord, I pray for them on tonight. I pray, oh Lord, for Deacon Ball tonight. So much as he continues to work for this branch of Zion, I pray for a speedy recovery. And I pray that you will guide him. God, I pray for our leaders on tonight. I pray for every person who gives of their time, energy, and effort to keep ministry moving in this place. Whatever they stand in need of, oh God, be Jehovah Jireh for them right now. Provide. Lord, I pray for every person who has to sacrifice to work in ministry. I thank you that people are willing to commit to not just being spectators, but are willing to get their hands dirty in the vineyard. Your word says that the harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. We thank you for the few laborers we have here at Macedonia Baptist Church of Baltimore City. But Lord, I pray for another generation that would come up to take up arms. You showed us on Sunday that there are 7 generations in this church. And 7 is the number of divine completion, oh God. It's no coincidence that we're serving 7 generations. Lord, give us the wisdom, the anointing, the spirit, the guidance, the resources to serve 7 generations at the same time. Lord, I pray for resources for this church. Lord, our building needs a whole lot of work. And Lord, I'm coming to you honestly. I don't have time to be fancy about it. I don't need the flowery language. We need resources for this place to grow, oh God. Lord, I just pray that you'll open the windows of heaven and pour out a blessing that there shall not be room enough to receive it in this place. We just need resources to do ministry, oh God. There's children who can't read, oh God. We have ministry to do. This is not about us having bigger buildings. This is about saving souls, oh God. This is not about just being fancy. This is about delivering people with mental health issues, God. This is not just about being cute on Sunday morning. This is about transforming lives in your name, oh God. Lord, we need the resources to make it happen. We need financial resources, oh God, so that we're not like other churches that made the mistake of living week to week, oh God. Pray for personnel resources. I pray that you'll send the right people to serve in this ministry with the right spirits and the right skill sets and the right spirits and the right skill sets and the right mentality to willing to serve with excellence in this ministry. God, I pray for strength as a pastor tonight. I need your strength. I love what I do. I love these people, but I need your strength. We cannot do this without you, God. Just be here. Honor the fact that we are just your children calling on Father's name. Honor that your creation desires its creator. And we'll give your name all the glory, honor, and praise. Lord, you are still our great King of Kings, our great Lord of Lords. Lord, you're still the one who fights battles we didn't even know we were in. You are still our protector from dangers we can't even see. You are still our friend when we have no friends around us. You're our parent when our own guardians have given up on us. Lord, you are everything. Lord, I pray that as we leave this place, as we leave this moment in this season of fasting and prayer, that we will never forget what we have started in this moment. That in 150-year celebration, revival is taking place in this house. Bless us on this Sunday as we celebrate not only the death on a Friday, but the resurrection of your Son on a Sunday. Thank you for reminding us that you're not just the God of life, you're the God of death, that nothing that is bound can stay bound by your power. So for everybody who thinks that something is dead in their life, God, bring about a resurrection in their lives. Resurrect dead relationships. Resurrect dead dreams. Resurrect dead hopes. Resurrect dead church members. Resurrect dead people. Resurrect. Just show off your resurrection power. In the name of Jesus, we say thank you, God. And it is in the mighty and precious name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ, we pray. On tonight we say, amen, amen, and amen. Before we close, I have one question to ask, and I'll let you go. And for people who are watching online, you're more than welcome to answer in the chat. I'll take a look at it later. Because of how powerful prayer and testimony has been, I just wanted to take a litmus test of the folks in the room. We're after revival, we're going to go back to Bible study, but what I'd like to do is to add praise and worship as well as some prayer and testimony as a part of that Bible study experience. All right. I take that as a sign of approval. Okay. So what we do is, I am a respecter of time, so what I'm thinking is what we'll do is we'll start Bible study with praise and worship and testimony at 6:30. And from 6:30 to 7, we'll have that time. And then from 7 to 8, we'll have Bible study. Is that all right? What we'll do is we'll start that in May. With David, we'll talk. We'll start that in May. All that good stuff. But thank you all for tonight. Please travel safe home. People don't know how to drive in the rain. Amen. God bless you. We love you. And we'll see you next week. Take care. Revival starts on Wednesday. Revival starts on Wednesday. Reverend Dr. George Parks will be sharing. Spread the word. Tell somebody about it. And we'll see you next week. God bless you.
Joy.